where do I think the future is? You know, I always forget how engrossed I am in this world. And, you know, even like 10 years ago when I was working in drug development, developing drugs against aging, and I would like drop into a conversation, like someone would be like, what do you do? And I'm like, oh, I'm developing drugs to slow aging. And they'd be like, what? And I, you know, and I become so matter of fact about it because it's the world that I live in. And it's, you know, it's for me, it's like a given. It's like, you know, in the future, aging in the way that it exists now will not exist in the future. And, you know, the average person finds it very hard to get the head around that, because as far as the average person's concerned, you know, aging is something that's not very pleasant, but, you know, it's a natural thing that we can't do anything about. So, you know, it is just the way it is, you know. But now, you know, the science really shows that it doesn't have to be like that. You know, there's been huge breakthroughs. And I think as more people become educated on this, they do start to go, okay, you know, maybe if I had better health for longer, I'd be open to thinking about aging in a different way. Because at the moment, people just think of aging as negative and a decline and, you know, ending up in an awful state in a care home, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. But I think that in the future, the way that we think about cancer now will be the way that we think about aging. So 50 years ago, cancer was kind of considered as like what aging is. Like, it's this terrible thing, but you can't do anything about it. It's therefore bad luck, get on with it. Now, if anyone had that opinion towards cancer, there'd be outcry. It would be, no, what is the treatment? What can we do? You know, because it's known there's things that can be done about it. So I think in the future, people will think it's inhumane to let somebody get to the state where, you know, they are have, you know, Alzheimer's and a frailty and can't support or, you know, live independently, because there are things that people are going to be able to do about it. So people will think, well, no, I'm not going to be like that. And I'm going to demand that there's things that can be done, because there will be. So mm-hmm. That's where I think the future's going.
And I also think that we don't necessarily know yet what the future holds in terms of, I always say to people around me that it's like, hey, we don't really know how your future would look if you would start, I don't know, from when you're 30, 40, 50 or whatever, to do like all the right things to address all of the hallmarks of aging. We don't know, because what we can see, yes, the blue zones are some examples, but still they're not doing like all the things that could be done. And as you say, most people are like, well, aging, I just will experience a slow decline and it will be terrible. But again, it doesn't have to be that way. And I think that is what individually with our companies and collectively as people in this industry, we are all trying to help other people with. If you found this video helpful and want more, then check out the full video interview with Dr. Nichola from the link in the description. While if you want to test out her second generation super innovative NAD booster, then you can get 20% off by using our code BeyondSapiens20. Lastly, if you're looking for an all-in-one solution for your health and longevity, then check out our longevity coaching program. It's a 3-month, fully customized one-on-one coaching program that will set you on the path to optimizing your health and longevity. You can learn more about it and request more info by visiting the link in the description. Thanks a lot for watching, subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you in the next one.